See, and the vinyl corner, Nico, I'm back to make a response to your 800 subscribers contest. Congratulations, Nico. 800 subscribers, that's a lot, I think, absolutely fantastic. But you deserve all of them. You have a very, very great channel, and I have learned very, very much about watching your channel. But for this contest, you wanted us to show and talk about autographed vinyl. And I'm sorry, it's going to be very, very short because I don't have that much. I never go for collecting autographs when I go to a concert. I've only done it once. And I'll show you that, and that's not even a vinyl. So, but I have a little bit. And first, I'd like to talk about why I don't go for it. I just when I'm at these concerts, I never stay to get these autographs. When I'm at a concert, I'm out partying, and I'm long gone before they come out again. So I've never really gotten any, and to me they don't have more value to me if they have an autograph. So I just really don't care about it, if you can say it like that. So the few I have, I just have because the artist did it themselves without me asking for it. So and the one everybody knows, it's Derek Higgins Flyover, and he did an autograph at the bottom there. So I didn't ask for it, but he did it anyway, and that's okay. To me, it doesn't get better value, but it's kind of nice that he just did it anyway. That was the first, and the second one is by Tim Christensen, and I bought this album from his webpage. And because I did that, he made a signature. I don't know if it's possible to see it over his head there. Yes, it is a little bit. So, Tim signed this Paul McCartney live album for me, but yeah, that's alright. And the only time I asked for an autograph was when I... maybe I should start over again. In the 90s, also now, I was. But in the 90s, I was very, very big fan of this Danish guy called Allan Olsen, and he had just released a best of album. It was this Allan Olsen En Gros. And he went on a solo tour, and I actually saw him two times at this tour. And the last time I saw him, it was in a small movie theater, and there were only about 200 people or something like that, and we were sitting and waiting and having a beer, and then he suddenly came out to us before the concert and asked if people were all right and if they had something to drink, and he said cheers, and I'll come back in a minute and start this show, and if everybody wants to, I will give you an autograph, and I will do that now. And I sat there, all right. And I was there with my cousin, and he said, Carsten, I have some paper, you can go up there and ask him for an autograph if you want to. And I said, yeah, well, all right. If he He insisted then my cousin tore a page out of his small calendar, and I went up there and asked him if he could sign this, and then he did, and I told him that I was at his concert just a few weeks ago, and he said, "Oh no, then you know everything I'm going to say." I said, "Yeah, well, I don't care, I like it anyway." So he asked, wrote here in Danish, he wrote, "Kære Carsten, velkommen tilbage," and signed it at Noten, and this means, "Dear Carsten, welcome back," and he signed it, whoops, sorry. And the date was the 24th of November in 1998, and he signed it, Alan Olsen, of course. So this is all I have, Mikko. I'm sorry I don't have any more, but again, congratulations with your 800 subscribers. Contest, absolutely fantastic. If you're wondering what we're listening to, we're listening to Quiet Riot, Condition Critical. I got it already. A great album that I've been enjoying today. Well, that was it for me, Mikko. I hope you liked it anyway, and have a nice Saturday, everybody. Bye-bye.